So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247 where we will discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are important for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon, and also you can join this Telegram group where you can ask any doubt and there will be a quiz for you all, and you can also have the information regarding the latest videos. Right, so let's begin with the very first question, which says, in how many districts Vigyan Jyoti program has been implemented by the Department of Science and Technology? And remember, the Department of Science and Technology has completed 50 years this year, and this program, Vigyan Jyoti program, has been implemented by the Department of Science and Technology. And the question is, in how many districts it is now being implemented? So recently the second phase of Vigyan Jyoti program has been launched by the department, and from now this program will be implemented across 100 districts in the country. Kitne districts mein? 100 districts mein ab isko implement kar diya jayega, and currently it is being implemented in 50 districts. So abhi ye kitne districts mein hai? 50 districts mein hai, aur iske aage badha ke kitna kar denge? 100 districts mein. All right, and guys, this program was launched to encourage girls to take interest in science and build career in the STEM fields. Now what is this STEM? It's science, technology, engineering, mathematics. So girls, jo girl students hai, unko encourage karne ke liye, so that they can also take interest in science and pursue their career in the STEM fields. This program Vigyan Jyoti was launched by the Department of Science and Technology. Pehle 50 district mein tha, and now in the second phase, 100 districts, in 100 districts it will be implemented. Okay, so therefore the correct answer to this question, guys, is option E, 100. Right, option E is the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 2. In which state ESIC has partnered with National Health Authority to upgrade medical infrastructure under Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana? So we all know better about this scheme, Ayushman Bharat. Ayushman Bharat mein kya hai? Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana mein government is providing 5 lakh insurance to all the families, to all the eligible families who are eligible under this Ayushman Bharat Yojana. And under this Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, ESIC Employee State Insurance Corporation has partnered with National Health Authority to upgrade the medical infrastructure. So the question is, in which state ESIC is doing this? So guys, the state is Maharashtra. Option A, Maharashtra here is the correct answer. And is news mein isse zyada detail mein jaane ki koi zarurat nahi hai. Just remember, ESIC has partnered with National Health Authority to upgrade the medical infrastructure under Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana in Maharashtra. Alright, that's it. You just remember the name of the state, Maharashtra mein aisa hoga. Right. And now, question number 3. Consider the following statements regarding the World Bank report on road accidents and identify the incorrect statement. So recently, World Bank has released the report on road accidents, and the name of the report is what? It is Traffic Crash Injuries and Disabilities, the Burden on Indian Society. The name of the report is this, and it has been released by World Bank. Remember this, World Bank is headed by David Malpass. World Bank is headed by David Malpass, and who is the chief economist? It's Carmen Reinhart. Carmen Reinhart is the chief economist at the World Bank. And who is the CFO? So write down in the comments the name of CFO of World Bank. Right, and she is an Indian. Let me give you a hint. This report, guys, has been prepared in association with an NGO which is known as the Save Life Foundation. Remember the name of this NGO, Save Life Foundation. And this is, of course, to present the data related to road accidents across the country. Okay, and road accident is the 8th leading cause of the death globally. This report says that the road accident is the 8th leading cause of death globally. And total value of crash costs due to accidents stood at rupees 5.96 lakh crores, or you can say 3.14% of the global GDP. Global GDP ka 3.1% jo hai wo accidents mein jo cost bear karni padti hai usi mein chala jata hai. And in India there are 1% of the world's vehicle, and because of this just 1% of world vehicles, India accounts for 11% global deaths due to road accident and 6% of total road crashes. India mein puri duniya ki 11% road accidents hote hain, jo ki bahut bada number hai, jabki India ke paas world duniya ke jo vehicles hain uska keval 1% hai. And uske bavajood bhi India mein jo global deaths hain wo 11% of the global deaths hain due to accidents. Right, so this is very alarming for all of us. So gaadi aaram se chalaya karo. Now let's come back to the question. you have to identify the incorrect statements. According to the report, road accident is the 8th leading cause of death globally. Yes, this is absolutely correct. This report says this. India accounts for 11% global deaths due to road accidents and 6% of total road crashes. This is also correct. And the report has been prepared by World Bank in association with the NGO, which is known as Save Life Foundation. So all the statements are absolutely correct here, which means and we have to identify incorrect statements. So none is incorrect, should be the correct answer. All right. And now let's move ahead to question number 4, which is very important question, because this is about the report Corruption Perception Index 2020, jo ki har saal kaun release karta hai, Transparency International, which is released by Transparency International and it is headquartered in Berlin, which is of course in Germany. So you have to consider these statements regarding this index and you have to identify the incorrect statement once again. So let's talk about this index. So Transparency International, which is headquartered in Berlin, has released this report, which is known as Corruption Perception Index, and this index ranks countries based on the perceived corruption in the public departments. जो उनके public departments हैं, वहाँ पे जो corruption हो रहा है, उसको ये measure करता है. And this time, in the year 2020, the total number of countries are how much? 180. And जो score की range है, that is from 0 to 100. 0 से लेके 100 तक का score का range है. 0 का मतलब है highly corrupt and 100 का मतलब very clean. 0 means highly corrupt country, while the score 100 means very clean country. And talking about the average score of all the countries across the world, then that is less than 50, only 43. Agar hum baat kare average score ki, to that is only 43. That means jo corruption hai, wo hamare khoon mein bas chuka hai. And talking about the rankings, the top countries, the rank 1 is shared by Denmark and New Zealand. Jo rank 1 hai, uspe do countries hai, Denmark and New Zealand, with a score of 88. Remember the score also, 88. The bottom countries are Sudan and Somalia with score of 12 each. Kitna score hai inka? Keval 12. And the highest scoring region, guys, is Western Europe and the European Union with an average score of 66. Average score of 66. And the lowest scoring region are the Sub-Saharan Africa with an average score of 32. Central Asia with an average score of 36. And Eastern Europe. And talking about our Pyara Bharat, then India's rank is 86 with a score of 40. And in the last Corruption Perception Index, we were at 41. And now, our rank is 40. Our score tha, that was 41, but now the score has been reduced to 40. And the rank last year, it was 80. Pichle saal kitni rank thi? 80 thi, but now, our rank kitni ho gayi? Kam ho ke 86. Okay. So, this is about the Corruption Perception Index. Now, let's come back to the question. You have to identify the incorrect statements. So, average score of all the countries is 43. This is also correct. India has been ranked at 86 with a score of 41. Yes, this is again the right statement. The countries at top are Denmark and New Zealand. This is also correct. So all the statements are once again correct here. Therefore, option D, none is correct, should be the correct answer. All right. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.